Good afternoon, Vice Mayor. Salamat po.
Yeah. A pleasure to see you and talk with you, Vice Mayor. I heard, you know, the commemoration of the 8th year of Yolanda will be marked by just simple rites. Maybe we can start with that. Ano po ang mga ginawa today in commemoration of Yolanda?
Well, it's as simple as having a mass. At the same time, may wreath laying lang tayo doon sa memorial marker at saka sa mass grave. Kasi until today, no? Until today, yung DNA testing na ginagawa supposedly doon sa mass grave with the saliva samples of the families, until today, 8 years after, hindi pa rin natatapos. No? So I think that's the call of the bereaved families kasi walang closure until and unless you are able to locate, finally get kahit bones na lang nila to be able to find a resting place for the families that they've lost during Super Typhoon Yolanda.
Yes, that's tragedy on top of a tragedy. I mentioned kanina po, Vice Mayor, na 1,062 missing. Yun po ba yung initial na numero na mga nawawala or is that the updated the balance of what used to be a bigger amount, a bigger number?
We will never know. We will never know. Kaya sabi yung sa official count less than 5,000. Yung iba naman the first count was almost 10,000. So we will never know, no? Pero yung we know doon sa mass grave pa lang more than 2,000 plus nandun sa mass grave. No? So that will tell you the story. Already with the more than 1,000 missing, then you would more or less have a figure already. No? So I'm sure it's higher than the official figure. Definitely. Definitely.
Vice Mayor, dun po sa mga bereaved families, especially dun po sa talagang nakaranas nung pananalanta ng Yolanda, ngayon po, ilang taon na lumipas, meron pa rin po ba ang nangangailangan ng support? Maybe psychiatric support or at least financial sa pag-move on doon sa nangyari?
Well, this afternoon, nandun ako sa Holy Cross, no, sa mass grave, where I was with a couple who lost both her siblings, who lost 2 children. Until today, yung panawagan nila ay sana mabigyan kami ng pabahay. They are still living in near sa danger zone. 8 years after, wala pa rin daw. Nag-apply na sila for pabahay. Until today, wala pa rin. No? Yung isa, I was able to talk, no? Again in one place where they lost both children. Then, binawi pa yung housing unit supposedly for them. Now, dahil again, no, you know, mag-election na, bibigyan uli sila ng pabahay. So sabi na that's an insult, no, to us. Ilan pa bang anak namin dapat mamatay bago kami bigyan ng pabahay, no? I think it's a continuing challenge, no, for many doon sa resettlement sites namin, no, sa pabahay. Still many of the resettlement sites wala pa ring pipe-in water supply. So supposedly, in 2018, nag-download yung luwa ng more than 500 million to fix the water system. No? So until now, hindi pa rin natatapos-tapos. Eh. So again, those are the challenges. Then another is pabahay. Pero kailangan daw namin ng hanap buhay naman. No? So in the same way with the pandemic, it's life or livelihood. Dito sa pabahay, may bahay nga kami. Pero wala naman kaming hanap buhay. No? So I think it's a continuing, no, challenge for LGUs. No? How do we build back better?
Daanan na rin po natin yung sinabi niyo, Vice Mayor. We have seen an outpouring of support, financial support, even from the international community para maka-rebuild ulit ang Yolanda. And hanggang ngayon, we are hearing problems po katulad ng sinabi niyo. What is keeping it from...
Rica, every 3 years ago, I remember, nag-investigation pa sa, I think, sa Kongreso, supposedly for the anomalies in the pabahay, substandard, and all the others. No? I think at the end of the day, no, 15,000 housing units were committed by NHA dito sa Tacloban. And apparently, 8 years after, nakikita natin, no, yung ibang housing units, nabubulok na lang, abandoned, walang nakatira doon. Bakit hindi pamigay na lang nila sa mga Taclobanons, no? Especially those who suffered. No? Especially yung talagang Yolanda victims. They were there 8 years ago. They were there in the storm surge trying to survive. Dapat bigay sa kanila. No? Rather than now they go there to the pabahay or the resettlement site, nakikita nila yung iba. Hindi nga taga Tacloban eh. Hindi dumaan sa Yolanda or may pabahay sila. No? So I think that really is a challenge, no? For all. Sana yung pabahay na ibibigay sana sa Yolanda victims, maibigay. At the same time, yung title, nandun na sila sa pabahay. Pero kailangan nila to have the security na pwede na ipamana nila after what they went through, ipamana na sa for the next generation to have that certificate of title na nakapangalan na talaga sa Yolanda victims.
Hindi ko po alam kung mawawalan na talaga ng ano, no, ng pag-asa. I don't even know which is worse, yung itong Yolanda o yung Marawi. But you see, lalo na po sa Metro Manila, parang ang layo ng Eastern Visayas, ang layo ng Marawi, and sometimes you feel that bibigyan lang ng attention yan kapag anniversary. And then mawawala na naman. My question to you, Vice, is this, no? I mean, you have congressmen, plural. You have a governors, plural. Wala pong na-accomplish? I mean, if at all, no? Please educate us. Ano na ang na-accomplish? Pinag-uusapan pa rin natin, kabahay.
Kabahay pa rin, yes.
Peter, no? Rica, kaya nga, no, we thank you, no, for even on once a year we have this kind of interview, kasi napapaabot sana natin, no, especially to the concerned government agencies, hindi lang every year, hindi lang kung malapit na naman ang election, no, these are just not numbers, eh. These are people with names, with experiences, who have lost loved ones, who have lost friends. Until now, I asked, and I was with one family this afternoon. They were telling, it's as fresh as November 8, 2013. Parang 8 years na nga. Pero if you talk to them, it feels like it just happened today. And, mm-hmm. and to ease their suffering, sabi nga nila sa akin, kahit naman lang, bigyan kami ng pabahay, at least it would ease a little bit of our what we went through. Kaya usapan dito sa Tacloban, I tell you, dati may BC and AD, before Christ, after Christ. No? Dito sa Tacloban, it's before Yolanda, after Yolanda. And everyone, wow, has a story to tell. How they survived and how they were able to get over it, how they were able to move on and bounce back. But that's our story here in Tacloban.
To the Taclobanons at saka yung mga taga-Eastern Visayas, this is like a pandemic, ano? Of sorts, kasi ang tagal-tagal na nito eh. Like, again, let me probe, Vice Mayor, with your permission, ano? So anong nagiging problema? I'm sure hindi naman budget ang problema. Ang dami-dami pera ng gobyerno. Is it about government incompetence or politics rearing its ugly head?
Well, for me, Peter, no, yung dapat mauna na huli, yung nahuli, yung ang nauna. No? So after Super Typhoon Yolanda, they were in a hurry to put them in resettlement sites, only to find out after all the developers had started, no, buying agricultural land and converting them into socialized housing, then they realized one thing. Wala palang water supply doon kasi it's 10 kilometers away from the city proper. So walang water supply. Only to find out na nandoon na lahat, then, oh, walang tubig pala. So, kaninong problema yan? Sa NHA pa ba? O kaninong problema yan? No? So, kaya yung ngayon there's a proposal for a Department of Disaster Resilience, parang FEMA sa US, no? Wherein may isang ahensya lang dapat. No? After every calamity, dapat in charge na. Hindi kagaya dito. No? Problema sa pagkain, ano, si DSWD, problema sa pabahay, NHA. Problema sa water supply, baka sa luwa. Problema naman sa kung ano-ano lang, iba na naman yung problema, no? Sa dito, sa inyo, Meralco, dito sa amin, Leyeco, sa in terms of electricity. So may pabahay pa rin dito, na wala pa rin electricity. No? So may pabahay rin dito, yung apparently, yung drainage system, may problema. No? So you see all these sorts of problems cropping out, no? Wherein you are a victim twice over. Na Yolanda ka na nga eh. Biktima ka pa rin, no? So that is so sad, no? Whether it's government incompetence or the slow pace of because of bureaucratic red tape or whatever, no? But again, 8 years is 8 years. Hindi na may babalik sa amin yung 8 years, Peter and Rica. No? That is something that we have to live with for the rest of our lives. At the same time, now we're facing the pandemic, no? It makes matter worse, no? Makaka-recover pa lang kami sa Yolanda. Tinamaan na rin tayo ng pandemic. So all the more na mahirap. So we get a lot of requests nga for not only for pabahay, kahit diaper at saka gatas, hinihingi pa rin sa amin, no? It just goes to show, no, how difficult life is, especially with the pandemic.
Nauungkat natin, sir, yung ating mga yung hinihingi natin, hinahanap natin from the local government, even from the national government. Let's look at the private sector. Paano po, meron po bang tumutulong hanggang ngayon mula sa private sector?
Well, in the early days, we have private sector. We have the international community. We have the NGO, the INGO. No? But at the end of the day, dito yung bumabalik-balik na lang sa amin, I think you all heard it. It's the Tsuchi Foundation. No? Talaga tumulong sa amin. In the early days until today, bumabalik-balik sila. No? And we are thankful to them, especially to the INGO, really, to the whole community. Kahit sa inyo, in ABS-CBN and all. No? Without your support, no, hindi kami makakabangon. Hindi kami makakabang. Kung kami-kami lang, with the government only, it's because of the INGO. That's why we have a story to tell na how fast the recovery was in Tacloban City, only because of the international community, the INGO, NGO, and the many who lent a helping hand to Tacloban. Parang United Nations kami in those days, no? Because maraming talaga tumulong sa amin. That's why we were able to recover faster than Haiti, no? And the other countries devastated by the same magnitude of calamity, no? Dito sa Tacloban. Kasi it takes 5 to 8 years, eh. But dito sa amin, around 5 years, supposedly. Then tinamaan tayo ng pandemic.
Okay, so you're saying, Vice Mayor, na ano, Tacloban is in a better place than the other locales na tinamaan ng Yolanda?
Yeah, definitely, Peter. No? Thanks again to all. No? We are in a better position because of the billions that have poured into our city. No? Because we were the ground zero of Super Typhoon Yolanda. So kami, we took the bulk of the many aid from other countries, no? Dito sa Tacloban. Yeah. No? So, so we're thankful for that.
Let me go to the... uso ngayon ito, Vice Mayor, eh. Let's go towards the accounting. Dahil alam ko na ang tagal-tagal na pinag-uusapan yung magkano ba ang total ng international aid na dumating, magkano ang ginasta, ilan pa ang unaccounted for?
Well, Peter, that's what we also want to know. Eh. Kasi again, no, if with the aid that has poured in, yes. And we know, no, the aid that has poured in after Super Typhoon Yolanda, then gusto natin din malaman, no, kasi unfair naman, no, sa the national government in the past administration din to say that hindi umabot sa amin, no. And you have to know, no, people also have to realize Super Typhoon Yolanda is not Tacloban. It's the whole Yolanda corridor yan, eh. Kasama yung Tacloban. Umabot pa yan hanggang Estancia Iloilo yan, eh. Yung tinamaan ng Super Typhoon Yolanda. So people have to know, yung bigay ng international community and the other government, hindi lang lahat dito sa Tacloban. It's the whole Yolanda corridor. So but then again, we need to have an accounting to let us know ilan ang pumasok, kaninong LGU, how much did they receive, then what happened afterwards. Kasi usually, blame natin yung national government. in the past administration. We have to know that bumigay rin, tinatawag natin refunds, assistance for Yolanda funds. So kailangan accounted for. Para yung LGU would also be transparent and accountable. Anong ginawa niyo sa pera na binigay from the national government to the LGU, sir?
And who's supposed to be doing the accounting, Vice Mayor?
Well, supposedly at that time, we have that Yolanda Rehabilitation. At the same time, we have the DILG naman. No? So the DILG and the DBM, I think, should be in a better position to give us a full accounting of the aid we received for Super Typhoon Yolanda and magkano ang na-receive ng bawat LGU na tinamaan ng Super Typhoon Yolanda.
Vice Mayor, about budget naman po yung tatanungin ko. We do receive budget yearly para nga po dun sa ating mga LGU. Ngayon po, may dagdag na naman na pandemya para isipin ng gobyerno natin at ng local government most especially. Nag-aalat pa rin po ba tayo ng portion of the budget for the Yolanda victims kahit na majority na po ay ginagamit na sa pandemya yung kanilang local budget?
Well, apparently, no, all of us have been affected naman by the pandemic, whether you're Yolanda victims or not. No? So, doon nakatutok lahat. Eh. So, in a way, no, kasama pa rin sila doon. No? But not necessarily specific na para lang sa Yolanda victims. Eh. Kasi tinamaan naman tayo lahat ng pandemic. So, all the aid, kasama naman sila lahat, mga Tacloban's.
Mm-hmm. While we're talking about COVID-19, Vice Mayor, let's drill down dito sa Tacloban City. Kumusta na po ang ano na pong alert level kayo diyan at kumusta ang daily new cases and hospital utilization?
Sa amin sa Tacloban is tawag na sa GCQ, no? So very very low. We're less than 10 cases a day. So in fact, the other day, nag-zero naman dito sa Tacloban. So we're doing a full blast in the vaccination. Hopefully, no, maabot na namin yung herd immunity. We're 50%. Hopefully, maabot-abot namin talaga yun. No? So for us naman, people have been very cooperative naman in terms of vaccination. In fact, the local government unit has been providing incentive. Kahit lang pamasahe, binibigyan sila. Basta magpabakuna lang sila. So I think the efforts of DOH with the City Health Office has been very, very effective naman in encouraging people to get vaccinated.
And no problem with the supply of vaccines, Vice Mayor? I mean, talagang dating at dating ang mga bakuna?
Yeah, yung problema na lang tayo is not bakuna. Yung problema na lang natin kung dapat mabakunahan yung mga tao. No? So we have to keep on telling them kasi dito sa atin sa Tacloban, I think in some other LGUs, hindi maiwasan no, with a lot of misinformation. Akala nila magpabakuna ka, magiging zombie ka. No? So sabi namin malayo pa yan kasi anong variant pa lang tayo, Delta. Malayo pa ang Zeta. No? Hindi tayo magiging zombie yan. So kasi there's a lot of misinformation, especially among the senior citizens.
Yes.
Among the senior citizens, there's always the apprehension to get vaccinated. No. So I think that's the challenge that we have.
Okay.
Vice Mayor, yan din po yung pinag-uusapan namin ni Sir Peter kanina, eh, no? Na parang do we really see yung push ng gobyerno na magkaroon ng information dissemination tungkol nga po sa pagbabakuna? On your end, Vice, ano pong ginagawa ninyo para po ma-address yung hesitancy ng senior citizens most especially?
Well, we have to go around. So, yung ginagawa nang dito sa Tacloban is yung pangbakuna, we're going to the barangay level na. No? So they're the ones going to the barangay at umiikot sila sa barangay. Kasi to take away the vaccination hesitancy, especially among senior citizens and mga PWD. No? So ginagawa na nila ngayon. So now, minors na kami. 12 to 17 na kami ngayon dito since last week. So nag-umpisa na kami yung minors, so below 18. So very positive din yung response. No? Mahaba ang pila, nagpapabakuna na yung mga minor de edad. So I think we're doing well dito naman sa LGU.
Yeah. And we're ending on a high note, Vice Mayor, because of that good news. Congratulations. And kahit na ginugunita po natin ngayon yung ikawalong anibersaryo ng Yolanda, I'm sure, sabi nga nila, there's a light at the end of the tunnel, at least in as far as the pandemic is concerned. And kudos to you and the local government unit. Vice Mayor Jerry, maraming salamat po.
Thank you. At the end of the day, we're stronger than the strongest typhoon. Mga taklobanong kami, mga waray-waray. Mag-isog, matatang.
Ayan.
So, thank you.